Hey there everyone, Rob Grant here with BIMsmith. Just wanting to do a quick video about type catalogs. So one of the questions we receive on a regular basis about are the content that we create that has a lot of families is how do you manage those families? And the number one answer when there's multiples of a style or a model or whatever it might be is type catalogs. And so I'm going to review some of the type catalog features or functionality, and we're going to go over that real quick. So I'm ironically working on my house here, kind of my home office. Wanted to do a little bit of furniture layout, and I got a type catalog dialog that came up, and so I wanted to go over that. So I'm going to load a family. My shortcut is LF, and I've already navigated to the Imperial Furniture Systems standing desks, and I'm going to load a standing desk family. And so what you see here is the dialog for type catalogs for families. So I'm going to look at these. I personally like a deeper desk just because I have a lot of paperwork and because I stand, so it tends to be a little bit more enjoyable. So I'm going to look at the ones that are 2'6" deep. And so one of the things you'll notice is that I was able to select a bunch of them at once. So let's go over that really quick for selection. So if you actually click and hold, you can drag down and select a bunch of types all at once. The other way to do it is if you select one and you hold shift and you go down to the bottom, you could select multiples. So if I knew I wanted all of them, I could do it that way. But if I knew I wanted exactly in 1 foot increments, I could select one, hold control, and say, okay, I want the 48 and the 60 and the 72. And now I know I've got the 3 foot, the 4 foot, the 5 foot, the 6 foot. And so I can say, okay. And then I've got now in my furniture systems, a furniture system standing desk, and I've got the four that I selected and loaded. So now I could go ahead and I could say, okay, I want to place one. Whoops, I didn't mean to double click that. I could take that in here. I've got one family. I can bring that in, place it against the wall, and now I've got a standing desk. A little bit narrow for my liking, so I can go here and I've got my multiple options. I could say, okay, I want the 60 inch wide one, and then I could come here and copy that over to that wall so that there is one for my wife as well. And if she says she doesn't want one as big, I can change that very easily. If she says she doesn't like the deeper ones, and then I can come here and I go, oh, wait a minute, she wants a smaller desk. So I can go here. There's multiple ways to reload from the type catalog. So the number one way is you can actually click on the family, right click, say reload, and it will actually open up the folder where the family was last opened from or saved. So if you are downloading content from BIMsmith Market, what will happen is it actually saves it to your download folder. If you move that family, you just got to remember where you moved it to so you can re-navigate to that family to reload the type catalog. In this case, it's a system one out of the box, so it loaded the right folder. So I will go ahead and select that once and say open. And now I could come in here and I could say, okay, so I think she only wants a 4 foot desk that is 2 feet deep. So I could select just that one. I could say, okay, I can go ahead and I can change it to the 48 by 24. And now she's got herself a desk that suits her needs, right? Super handy. So this is a very quick way to have multiple families all at once. So the thing to remember is the type catalog has to have the same family name, or the same file name, apologies, as the actual family file. So if it does not, it will not work, and it's gotta be exactly the same. So if that was changed from a dash to a space, it will actually break it. So if I came in here, and move this out for a second, if I came here and I said reload, and then I open that, I don't actually get the dialogue. So that's not a good thing, really. So it didn't do that right. So if I come back in here and I rename that back to its proper file name, I'm gonna say continue to that. I'm gonna move that out of the way again. And then I come back and I say reload. I'll get the dialogue again. And now I get my dialogue that asks me to specify the types. So that's super handy. So another thing to discuss really quick, so I'm going to do a quick detail component. So So if I say I know I only want two binomial dimensions, I could come and pick it here, or I could also filter it by the width, knowing that these are all 1.5. I could come here and I could say, okay, I only want 1.5 inch width in terms of this detail component. So not likely to use anything more than a 2x8 in my house, so I will select just those. I will say okay, and then I can come in here and say detail component, and I have exactly the detail components I want with a bunch of different options. So now I can start placing them, I can start changing them. I will say nominal cut lumber section. So I've got a few accidentally loaded, but there we go. That's how you have your detail components from a type catalog. So hopefully this answers type catalogs for our end users. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to put those in the section, in the comment section below. If you have any other discussions that you would like us to go over, please let us know. We would love to help you guys out, hopefully making Revit more user-friendly for you guys and a little bit more understandable. With that, have yourselves a great day.